Now, we realise there's a certain demographic feeling a little wanderlust right now, that real desire to travel somewhere, anywhere, overseas. But don't worry, it's coming.
Until then, you can live through this bloke. He's a Kiwi photographer who's become Insta-famous thanks to his pictures of one of the most amazing cities in the world. Here's US correspondent Anna Burns-Francis.
These days, the best view of New York is from your phone. And some of the most incredible pics are thanks to this guy, Matt Ritchie. Architect by day, Instagram influencer by night. He's been shared by some of the biggest accounts on the planet.
I mean, it's cool and, you know, it's just a number, but it's nice to have some appreciation and recognition of the stuff I've been making lately, yeah.
And it all started with the pandemic.
When it was COVID, all the things that you could do in the city, everything sort of shut down. And so my way of like filling out my time was to just go and take photos. And because I couldn't really leave the city too much, it was a great way of me to just explore as much as I could of New York.
That means shooting in all seasons. We thought it only fair we get a taste of it ourselves, meeting up on a -5 day.
How many layers are you wearing to shoot out in -9, -11 degrees?
Just enough to probably have like a little bit of mobility there.
Yeah, you can just move the Michelin man and take your photographs.
Exactly.
And what better weather to get some pictures than in the blizzards that hit New York in winter? I want you. This video has had more than 5 million views.
Yeah, and no, I do actually prefer the blizzard though.
Do you? Does it make for better photographs?
It does, there's no one out on the streets.
From snowstorms to sunrise, you'll find Matt out on the streets.
At the moment, getting up at 6 a.m, but...
That's not too bad.
Well, it's not too bad, but those summer sunrises, you know, you've got to get up at like 4 o'clock for them, so...
there's a limit to how early you get up for a good photograph.
I miss most of them.
And while he'll go to great lengths to get a good photograph, there are some limits.
Do you go to New Jersey much? And look
Why do you go that way? Oh, yes.
Why would you go to New Jersey? Yeah.
To get pictures like this, of course.
The only reason I go to New Jersey is to look back at New York.
Manhattan.
Yeah.
But Matt's best view to date is from here, New York's newest skyscraper. This video sending him soaring past another million views. New York, from the 91st floor of number one Vanderbilt.
The algorithm works in weird ways, so my favorite photograph might not be the algorithm's favorite photograph. People like videos these days, so my videos seem to do pretty well lately.
Wow, this is amazing.
It really is incredible up here.
The best place to take photographs in all of New York, do you think?
Oh yeah, if not the world.
And yeah, I did take some videos, and they're nowhere near as good as Matt's.
I really like the community that it creates. I really like how people want to reach out and meet up for shoots and, you know, the compliments that you get about the photographs. And yeah, it's a really good way to connect with people.
Of course, once you're really popular, you can start turning a profit off views like these. And Matt is aiming high.
Who knows, maybe one day. I think I would like to give it a full-time go one day.
New York is his Instagram oyster.
Those are beautiful images. You know, I've almost forgotten that there's a world out there. Imagine being able to travel one day at some stage in the future.
Yeah, one day. No, I mean, not immediately, obviously. No. One day. And in the meantime, I'll go home and, you know, put some more chocolate in my home isolation kit.